about STEM, we're talking about all these different subjects, which at school we teach separately, but actually once you leave school and go into the real world, they all tend to merge and kind of come into one.
Being given a chemistry set as a child, my parents for some reason just left me with methylated spirits and all sorts, and I used to try and make explosives.
So it takes a little while. The energy of the light and the energy, the light takes, the photon takes about a million years to get out across the sun. So it randomly bounces around the photon. So I should say it's a lot of young people. But have you ever seen drunk people try and walk? They stagger, I saw it. Shankly, I have done it as well. It's a bit like that, quite a drunken walk. The photons are staggering around. Eventually, we can use sound waves to look inside the sun. And as material comes up, it moves out. And the best way to describe it is, it's a bit like this is how it's described to me, a pot of boiling tomato sauce. But the thing is, when we went to the moon, human beings went to the moon, we didn't really have much understanding of the space environment. And then these things, these coronal mass ejections are flying around, and they have huge doses of radiation with their glasses. So that's one of the big problems of going to Mars. And they haven't really come up with the best, and this is seriously the best, technological kind of solution to solving this and going from high tech to low tech here. Is storing all the waste produced by human beings at the front of the spacecraft. And when one of these events is coming in, they orientate the craft to it, and everyone hides basically buying their own food. They make a shield of food in the front of the ship, and that's the best we've come up with yet.
My name's Chris Brockley-Blatt. I am a rocket scientist. The first one I ever worked, I've designed a filter ball system for something called Beagle 2. Yes, it crashed into Mars, and my mum is so proud that I've got junk on Mars.